This is a character that I had to rig to do Animation Mentor, the online school, because they only support Maya, and I had to do everything myself. So this is an example of something very complex that you can achieve in cinema. And I just want to go through real quick and, you know, move them around a little bit. This is all, we're running a laptop, and now we're recording the video, so it's going to run a little slower than normal, but you can grab the different elements, and I've got them set up with an IK spline right now. You can move them around. Let's see, let's zoom up on the head. I've got a ton of facial controls built in, so I can grab any one part, and all these controls are linked to, that's not a good one. Let's grab this one. All these are connected to morph tags so that you can control every little aspect of everything this guy does. Let's see, where's his eyes? I got these individual eye controllers, and using Expresso, I built all this user data, and, you know, just based on these sliders, I can slide things around and do morphs and just tons and tons of things. Hey, we just got started. You didn't really miss anything. So let's look at some different things you can do with rigging. All right, the main rigging, and we're covering rigging, is if you have MOCCA. There's a ton of things you can do even without MOCCA, but I don't know where one starts and the other begins because I've always had both. So this assumes you have the character animation module, which of course is called MOCCA because they call everything with some sort of coffee name. So let's see. Let's start out with morph tag because it's pretty straightforward and really versatile. I'm just going to create a cube and give it a few subdivisions, not too many. And I'm going to make it editable by hitting the letter C. And now, of course, we can manipulate the points in the polygons. So I'm going to create a morph tag. I'm going to right-click right on it, go to Character Tags, and go to Morph. And let's kill that. It'll open, whenever you click on the morph tag, it'll open up this menu right here. Now, there's the base morph, which is the shape at its default. And then it already created a new morph target. And right off the bat, I could start selecting points. And let's say I drag these down. I grab these, and I'll drag those down. It's pretty random. I'll grab this. All right, so there's something. And I'll say add another morph target, so it would be a second one. And I'll grab these points. And I'll pull those out. And let's add one more morph. And you see, whenever I add a morph tag, it goes back to its default shape. And let's go to a different mode. Let's go to polygon mode. Now, you shouldn't change the we're changing the shape, but we are not adding or subtracting any polygons from it. It's got the same count, all the same points. All right, so we've created these three morph tags. I'm just going to rename them by double-clicking 1, 2, 3. So as simple as that, I'm going to go from edit mode to animate mode. And now, I'm going to go into, like, the modeling tool, so it's just a cube. I'm not even going to have the cube selected. And as I drag these sliders, you just slide from 0 to 100% each of those shapes I just created. The morph system is quite brilliant. I drag the second one. So now I've got both of those combined, or I can drag this other one and, you know, pull it down a little bit. I mean, that one's kind of funky. But even beyond that, like, okay, I drag that one, it goes out, but I can drag it to go negative, and the opposite will happen. If I pulled out 100 units to the right, when I go negative, it'll go 100 units to the left. You can go beyond 100% and have it go way out. So, you know, just because you make a morph, you're not limited to what you originally dragged it to. And everything combines, everything stacks on top of itself. In a nutshell, that's the morph tag. And you can use Expresso to start driving all the different tags and link those to different objects. But, I mean, you know, depending on what you're doing, there are tons and tons of uses for this morph tag. It's so nice. It uses very little memory. If you remember the old, I don't even remember what the old one was called, like the morph deformer or something like that. You used to have to create entire duplicates of the object and then relink each of the objects so you'd have the same copy of your whole mesh over and over and over again. This one, only the points you move to store it, and you don't have another object. There's no redundancy. It's super, super fast, super quick, super small. All right, so that was a cube.